Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm Lieutenant Commander George Likos. Dear Apostolos, thank you very much for the opportunity. Dear Admirals Karagiorgis and dear Admirals Christopoulos, thank you for the opportunity given to me to present this innovative and really important firefighting and evacuation simulators. In this presentation, I'll try to be 12 minutes. I'll try to make the connection between firefighting simulators, evacuation simulators, and safety, how they can enhance safety. So let's start. 100 years of safety. What we have learned from the foundering of the Titanic. 100 years ago, the foundering of Costa Concordia, we have learned that even state-of-the-art ships can, in state-of-the-art ships can occur very important accidents, incidents, catastrophes. So despite regulations, and what regulations, as Mr. Liapis said before with Ellen Oil, we have reactive actions and regulation for the accidents. After reactions to accidents, we have safety. Despite these regulations, some human factors and organizational issues still are present in all these accidents. This is the framework of Safety One. This is what we have done 100 plus years. We have Safety One. What is this? It means managing safety reactively. We suffer and then we have regulations. Is that good for our industry? It means reaction to accidents, and we focus only on the immediate causes that cause the specific accidents. Probably that's not a good solution, because we need a huge number of accidents to find all the root causes, and probably this will never build a safety culture on our industry. What is the framework we should establish in our industry? Probably it is safety too. Why? Safety research in all safety critical domains has revealed that if we are reactive, then we are not effective. What we should do? We should move from as few things as possible go wrong to ensure that as many things as possible go right. What it means? It means now that the spotlight, the focus now, is on raising the performance of our seafarers. This is the framework of safety too. It's the framework of proactiveness. We are proactive in this safety too framework. What will happen when there is a gap of safety related fire incidents? This is our image from fire catastrophes until our recent and well-known one, the Norman Atlantic. Okay, we don't know exactly what happened there, but probably there is a gap of safety. What will happen when there is a gap of safety about navigation? Probably collisions, grounding, and there is a need to safe evacuate a ship. Like this we have discussed a lot today about Costa Concordia. My approach about Costa Concordia has to do with this comic, because our captain was coordinating the safe evacuation of his ship from his safe rescue boat. That's not good for our industry. So what is common? The common on all incidents is human factors, the inavailability of people to deal effectively in emergencies. So human beings, by their nature, will still make mistakes. Our approach is these mistakes not to result at catastrophes. The framework that very well captures the human factors in our domain is the framework of non-technical skills, or soft skills, or crew resource management skills, that is the cognitive, social, and personal resources skills that complement technical skills of our seafarers and contribute to safe and efficient task performance. Is what an everyday good captain will do in his routine day. So this is my PhD work with Professor Vendikos, and this is about situation awareness, decision making, communication, teamwork, leadership, managing stress, and coping with fatigue. What is the dominant non-technical skills in emergencies? Probably and definitely it is stress. What is stress in emergency situations? Stress can be very good depicted as a balanced mechanism between the demands of a situation and the coping ability of our seafarers. What is happening on emergencies? We have very big demands or stressors, speaking about stress, and the coping ability of our seafarers is not enough. That is what happened to the captain of Costa Concordia, to the captain of the Wall, and they leave very early the ship because the stress decide for them to fly the situation and not to fight the situation. So what can be done? This is the problem for me, for human factors, this is the problem. The problem is stress. How I can raise the coping ability of our seafarers? What is the recipe? What is the solution? The solution is train our seafarers in realistic and simulated environments. Hellenic Navy operates for more than 50 years firefighting and evacuation simulators. This is the firefighting training unit, and the other is the evacuation training unit. Let's have a closer look. We have firefighting training unit. Let's see some unique characteristics. First of all, we have safety. We train more than 1,000 trainees per year with no remarkable safety issues. No, not at all. Realism. Participants don't feel that they are at Scaramanga area where it is the location of the firefighting unit. They feel that like they fight a fire in a real ship on board the ship. Instruction. We use one trainer for five trainees. What it means, they always feel the instructor beside them. Repeatability. We use propane as fuel for the fire. That means we can make as many scenarios we like. We can repeat all the scenarios. Because we use propane, we are environmental friendly. All this facility is integrated, controlled by control room. We have three decks, and in this way, we can run multiple training scenarios. After the theoretical part of training, the participants get the hose range, where they get familiar with the use of fire hoses and the techniques we can use with one hose or two hose in the firefighting, and then they get to the demo area where they get familiar how to react effectively at a fire that has just ignited. Probably a video can speak more than me, so let's watch a small video from Hellenic Shipping Companies. These are the participants. With the yellow hat is our trainer. They are not actors. Look for the reactions. This is the cold training, and after successfully pass this training, we can enter the hot training part of our FFTU. It has three deck configurations. The first deck, the base deck, has engine room and electricity generating plant, as you see in this photo. The second deck is mess room and galley. And the third deck is exterior area, main deck, radar room, where we can simulate fire on a bridge. This is the radar. This is what's happening inside the hot training. As you see, the environment is full realistic, and the participants are full safe with PPE, with the suitable PPE. That was for the firefighting training unit. Let's have a closer look now at the evacuation training unit. We operate this training unit for more than 12 years. It has two deck configuration plus a sliding one, you see there, and again, we have control room. What is happening inside? We have moving obstacles from the trainer, so we can always change the environment, and some special obstacles like this crawling tube. Let's now watch again the same participants. They are seafarers in distress. They're trying to find their way out, and they cannot see.
κόσμο,
have closed their vision. Okay, so what Hellenic Navy now offers for the maritime industry? We offer for now two courses, advanced level ships firefighting, a 3-day course, and evacuation techniques personnel rescue, a 2-day course. And probably we can make customized training programs, courses according to the maritime industry needs. What is our evolution? We have just started research programs about human factors, mainly stress, because we can measure stress in these environments. We are in progress to be certified from a certified training center from a recognized organization. And we have ongoing projects to build a flooding training unit, leak simulator, with cooperation with Hellenic shipyards. We have just started there. This is the pictures from flooding training unit, how it will be. So the participants try to close some holes in the piping or at the bulkhead. And this is the model of our flooding training unit we are going to construct in cooperation with Hellenic shipyards. And this is my conclusion. I strongly believe that existing maritime emergency preparedness strategy can highly benefit from simulator-based training Hellenic Navy offers. Simulated environment like this one of Hellenic Navy can strongly help us identify human limitations. I'm closing my presentation with what I believe it's very important. Safety is a continuous fight with human nature. Hellenic Navy simulators can strongly help us discover this nature. Thank you very much for your attention.